like I've been listening to Tyson. Everyone says all praise yesterday, but his natural talent and his engaging personality and his physical size, he's going to be a big, big, big factor in boxing. I've said that after Latimer, he's going to be the next dominant heavyweight. But there's one kid in America that no one speaks of, and that's Deontay Wilder. He was on the Olympic team. He lost it, the big kid, and he's got good speed and power. And I think best talent is still going to be Tyson and Deontay Wilder.
Welcome to another edition of IMO Sports with Pedro Justice. There's only one Tyson Fury. There's only one Deontay Wilder. This is why you have to love heavyweight boxing. A 50-50 fight, the best versus the best. One man wins, and now the other man has to come back. The stories that are involved and at play right now puts boxing back on the map. Now, if you wanted Deontay Wilder to win last night and he didn't win, it's a tough morning. It was a tough night, but champions bounce back. And if you wanted Tyson Fury to win, you are happy right now. You're a celebratory right now. You are to the moon right now. You're excited. You're happy. But if you're a fan of boxing and especially heavyweight boxing, you are on top of the world right now. Think of the stories. Think of the intrigue. Deontay Wilder, the WBC champ, faces Tyson Fury, loses his crown to the Gypsy King. The Gypsy King regains a title, and then he gets the Ring Magazine title. He says he's a lineal champion. Now, guess who's out there? Anthony Joshua. He took a loss to Andy Ruiz, lost his belts. He had a rematch clause. He exercised it, got his belts back. Now he's a champion. So you have Tyson Fury as a champion. You have Anthony Joshua as a champion. You have Deontay Wilder. And Deontay Wilder has the opportunity to exercise a rematch clause. So anything Eddie Hearn is saying is bollocks, because Deontay has the option to exercise the rematch clause. That's why you negotiate. Now, based on the eardrum being ruptured after taking the shot behind the head, how long does it take to recover from that? Bob Arum is in for it. If Deontay Wilder wants to fight, we'll fight. If he wants to fight next year, we'll fight next year. So it seems as though we're going to get a fight, Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury, regardless. But will Deontay Wilder do it immediately? Deontay Wilder was not happy about the towel being thrown in. I think Mark Breland is the one who did it. He was upset. JD said he didn't do it. He didn't know why it was done. But regardless of that fact, no matter what happened, the end result is Tyson Fury is the champion. And now Deontay Wilder has to rise up and fight through what he's facing right now. Whether his team gets changed, gets added to, guess what? People are talking about boxing. So win or lose, people are talking about boxing. And if you are a fan of boxing, you got to be happy about that. Let me know what you think. Until next time, it's Pedro Justice.